Peace sign.
Hey, guys.
Oh, come on.
Lots of people watching up there.
It is packed. So why are you here today?
Really, right. Here for my nose and I have checked.
Mm-hmm.
Poll bill checked.
Mm-hmm.
And my treaty rights that are being violated.
Mm-hmm.
On a daily basis.
Thanks.
I'm also an Army veteran. Fighting
okay.
for fought for this country.
Uh-huh. Yep.
I'm fighting for my nation.
Uh-huh. We are heading out north. Apparently, they don't want people taping the security. City police.
Yeah.
So, this is the northeast corner of the Mall of America. The owners of the Mall of America, are Canadian, and I think that it's something to do with, like, the negotiations that happened before the event or whatever. Like, the police have not been trying to grab at people or anything, although they're circling around, recording, being kind of testy, but there are never usually protests here.
Thank you.
small talks on the megaphone over there. He said something about a demonstration. Everybody shouted him down.
Thank you.
people,
This is the Mall of America. Mall of America, Bloomington, Minnesota. It's Clyde Bellacourt right there in the middle there. So I did see a press release that Clyde was giving a press conference, and so this is the Mall of America, Bloomington, Minnesota. I was actually here the day this place opened, believe it or not. It's basically impossible to protest in here usually. I've never seen a protest here ever. There's a powwow in Minneapolis for many years, so a lot of tribes come from all over the region to powwow, and they come down here from all over, Wisconsin, places, Minnesota. What brings you here?
Well, it's about the island of war back up in Canada. You know, we're showing them that, you know, they have support, you know, from below the Canadian border, which is right here in the United States. This is one of many.
Yeah. Amazing turnout here today, don't you think?
Oh, agreed.
Yeah. Have you ever seen anything like this before in the Indigenous sort of world?
This is the first for me, you know. Especially me being of an Indigenous background.
Where are you from?
I'm from Minnesota.
Oh, nice. cool. Have you talked to a lot of people from different places that are here? Like, is there a lot of, from a lot of different areas?
Oh, I know.
You want to talk?
I repeat the question again,
yeah.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, yeah, well, have you talked to a lot of people from different places? Is this a large gathering from many locations going on here?
Oh, almost definitely, you know, that's from a lot of people in other states, you know.
Uh-huh.
But right here is ground zero, you know.
Uh-huh.
And because there's a lot of people are affected here, you know.
Yeah, totally. So do you think there'll be momentum? Do you think that this is kind of motivating people to keep rolling?
There was momentum in L.A., there was momentum in New York. Trust
yeah.
me, there's momentum here.
That's awesome. All right, is there anything else you want to add right now?
My name's Marky, and I'm idle no more.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Marky.
Well,
all right. Yeah.
My name is Dan. It's live on globalrevolution.tv.
It's cool.
So, yeah, live on the internet there.
Yeah, my marriage a little bit ago. I don't think so much BS before I leave.
Right.
But my name is Paul.
It's so cool to see this, though. All right.
Yeah, thank you.
We're one of the organizers of the PM State, so I'd like to say why, what brought you out, what was the reasoning behind doing
that? Wow, this is the 14th or 5th, because she's been on her mother's side for this long.
Speak up, it's loud in here.
We're out here to support Chief Teresa Smith here at us people in America because of what's happening there. We think that it's really strong to come together to support her through solidarity and show that we have the support for everybody in Canada. We may be separated by a border, but we're not mm-hmm. separated by who we are as a people. We're not separated by the government. So we're here behind you 100% all the way, and I just want her to know that this is why we're all here today to support the Aboriginal people and the First Nation people of Canada.
Have you ever seen anything like this happen before?
No, it's the first time.
It seems like it's a real change in how people look at these things.
Well, I mean, there's power in numbers.
Yeah.
And this is what Sean, like, this is over 500 years of oppression that we have deep down inside mm-hmm. of us. And it's coming out now. Like, this is what we can do. It may be peaceful, it may be calm, it may be sexual, but it's some way to show that we are a voice still. We can still be heard if we come together, you
mm-hmm.
know? And we still are doing it peacefully and not trying to do it by violence or something.
Can you say your name again?
My name is Michaela Shaw. I'm from Alaska and Ojibwe. This is my daughter, Mariah.
Thank you.
You guys traveled a long way too then. We live in Minneapolis.
Okay.
So, and the thing too is because the lifetime guard today, the youth are speaking their voices, and they mm-hmm. want to be heard as well, and I think through Facebook and through social media, we are able to do this.
Is there anybody else that you can give me like an interview with right now, quick? We got a live stream going on here, so what is live right now?
Okay, that's the white person.
Here, do you want to talk to the live stream? Can I get your shirt though?
Yeah.
Okay. So this is my friend. And he's got a really funny shirt called Fall of America with a Baphomet Wall of America logo. Like, it is one of the great satirical shirts. That's cool. I've seen
yeah,
it before.
No, that's, yeah, one of our West Bank friends who actually lives in Seattle now designed it.
Nice.
Yeah.
Did we never see any protests here at the Mall of America ever?
Well, that's because you can. I mean, honestly, the only reason we got away with this is because it was so big.
Yeah.
I mean, I know people that were terrified that this was going to be a bloodbath, and I'm just like, no, there's going to be like 5,000 people there. They aren't going to touch it with a 10-foot pole.
Yeah, there were hundreds of people here.
Yeah.
It was huge. So.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know how many actually showed up. I just know, like, what was on my Facebook and, like,
there's been things going on in malls with it. It's been kind
of it needs to keep happening because, like, I mean, when we were, you know, like, that's been a thing since we were, like, young kids. Or, like, malls are where people congregate. Romero made Day of the Dead to mock that, you know? They're gone.
Yeah.
You know, like, the whole mall culture thing, like, you know, that was fucking 35 years ago.
Exactly, and here we are. I'm just gonna grab a couple of little footage of the Aztec dancers and but thank you.
No worries.
So, yeah, people are mostly dispersed. The Aztec dancers came down here. If everything's chill, I might cut the transmission.
Great. Would you want to talk about why you're here today?
Did you talk to the internet about why you're here today, somebody?
Anybody would like to know more?
Well, the folks that organized this, they already went down that
way. Okay. Where'd they go?
We don't want to speak on behalf of
others,
but we're all here in support of, I don't know where, and respecting kitty rights all across the world, and that's the most important thing, is that we stand together in unity.
Mm-hmm. Cool. Well, thank you. Alright. So,
I don't see other people giving interviews right now, so I think I'm going to cut it off for the moment. But if anything else comes up in the next few minutes, I will definitely go live again. And this has been at the Mall of America, where there are never protests. It's been really cool. It's been really neat to see this kind of, like, rapid mobilization happening here in Minneapolis. So, that's been the Idle No More Mall of America protest. And for people in the Twin Cities, there is a Native PowWow going on this weekend at the American Indian Center on Franklin Avenue. So I think a lot of people are going to head back to that. So, over and out.